school, were you kind of like really trying to reach that cable? Was it far away? One of the other guys here, I can't remember who it was, look if you were reaching. I'll shorten that up. Yeah, I think you were reaching. I'm going to shorten yours up, I'm sure. Yeah, I remember. Had you lay down and you were practically horizontal there.
Yeah, I wasn't really sitting.
Yep. Copy that, sending cat. Let's take one step down. I want to see where that puts you here. Down one step. That'll be fine for this set. Excellent. And those things will not be in your way once you start zipping. That looks good. Just relax that hand. Excellent. Let's go zip.
On the other side. Alright, up to that top step. Alright, so first things first.
Did I turn so much?
Yeah. So, I'm going to steal that from you. You want your brake nice and far back. If it's right next to this pulley here, it lets you turn all over the place.
Okay.
You want it nice and back, and that'll keep you going straight. And the other thing that's very important is you never want to put your hand in front of your pulley.
Okay.
That's when you can get your fingers a little hard.
Okay.
So always keep it back right there. When you're in your riding position, you shouldn't have to move your hand at all.
Okay.
You just brake from right there. So we'll try to keep that brake just a little bit farther back, and you should be able to stay straight.
Okay.
All right. All clear on
initiation. So we both
demonstrated
how to self-rescue.
How not to do it.
Dip on. Don't wait. Almost everybody has to self-rescue on this first one. It takes a few to get the feeling of how braking works. That's why we start you out with the next two are going to be very similar to this.
He did it.
Oh, okay. Alright, find that top step. And this is like one more step.
He just did it.
This is the case of the guys using too much muscle to brake.
Yeah.
One more step up.
You're so strong, honey.
Don't need quite that much pressure.
Right. Step on up.
Yeah,
just step on up. What was that first zip?
It was not good.
Oh, it was you, wasn't it?
It was me. I was spinning around.
What I just told her?
Yeah.
You do that, okay?
Yeah.
So, yeah, what happened was, once you started zipping for some reason, you let this hand come forward. As soon as that happens, it allows you to turn.
Okay.
So keep that hand back. Keep your elbows out and up. That's going to make a nice framework for keeping you going straight. I think everything else is good. You had your legs out in front.
Step down.
So if you feel yourself starting to turn, resist that as soon as you can. Don't let it get too far. That makes it a little bit trickier to correct. Small stuff. Exactly.
I was trying to do it with my hand, but
this up here doesn't help much.
Yeah.
It's this one back here. If you use it as a rudder, you start to get out of line, you just use your finger or your thumb on one side or the other. Don't grab. That just gives you these jerky movements. Let that cable run right along the palm the whole time. Don't put real pressure on it. Just let it run across there.
Okay.
Copy that, sending cat. Just one step down, cat.
I can't.
That left
step
hand
down.
Nice and far back.
I'm gonna
put that finger through there. That all looks good.
photographer.
Seemed very comfortable and good at this. You're right up there. Copy that. Send an Abby.
Some ropes. A couple of shoestrings.
Right up to the front.
Step ladder.
And you
are
good to go.
Better, but I still turned a little bit, and I know I had my backhand.
Okay, well just quick
good. Good advice.
So, yeah, your legs are crossed, you got them out in front, you're keeping that hand in contact the whole time, I think you did. So maybe just a little bit more oomph than you're trying to correct. Try to prevent it from happening. Instead of trying to correct when it has happened, just try to stay straight the whole time. If you feel like you're getting a little bit off, like Sean said, make a little micro adjustment. If you adjust it the wrong way, you'll know right away, and then counteract. After this zip, it should feel pretty comfortable and easy to keep yourself going straight. So if you copy that, send in cap.
If you're drifting to, if your legs are kicking out to the right, thumb or fingers?
Don't overthink it. I don't have any answer for that.
Right.
Just whatever feels right. Just get those feet back in line. That's the thing. Keep your toes pointed right at Lauren. That'll help. Come on down a couple of steps. And try to relax and have fun. That's the most important thing. You're overthinking it, trying to go straight. It's going to mess you up. Just go with the flow. Try to go straight.
Like this, or should it be further back?
This is a perfect spot.
Okay. See, now I'm nervous.
You've already done it twice before.
I know. I don't know why I'm so nervous. Stupid thing on my head,
put it on me.
Relaxing is the key, I think.
Yeah, once you get that breakdown, you can actually start to enjoy yourself. Look
that
around.
Good.
Come on down. Off clear on sunrise. Off clear. You guys want
to go that way?
On this side. There's not quite as much room on this side.
Sneak this way.
Awesome. Widen up. Perfect. Whenever you're ready, great big deep knee bend. You'll feel it tighten up. Now you can lean back. Straighten your legs up. Nicely done. Come on around, cat. Go away. No, Sean, come on around. Right over there. That's good. I'm just going to wait there a moment for that rope to come back down.
I'm just going really, to.
This is the
down,
only
nothing.
One that you can actually close your eyes on. There's no eye closing.
Yeah,
there's
no to look, exactly.
It's also fun to kind of look straight ahead and look at the lovely bark on the tree.
This is coming.
Ambelé! You're going to put both hands right above that big knot right there. Just try to face the tree a little more square. Get your heels over the edge. You're ready. Great big deep knee bend. Lean on back, straighten your leg. There, please. Good. All right, cat, come on around. Spin the opposite way and relax there for a moment. When we get down to the next platform, you can see that this giant oak tree here is growing out of a rock. We split it right in two. It's about a 250-year-old tree. I like to call it, its official nickname is the Rock Oak. I like to call it Dwayne the Rock Oak.
Dwayne.
Ambelé! So, you're going to put both hands right above that knot. I'm going to do a couple of flips. Go ahead and turn and face Dwayne. Just like that. And a little bit more square these days. Flip those heels over. That's perfect. Whenever you're ready, great. And then you can lean back, straighten your legs, keep your feet right there. Very good.
And get ready to
go. Hey!
I could do more of that. Just like hang.
Yeah, those are like.
Done by hand with spike fibers to start with, and then block and tackle, pulleys, ropes, everything brought up with the head. Copy that, send it, Sean. That's in a cat. Just one step down towards me, cat. That's good. They make their hands into nice strangle positions. That's awesome. You're good to go. Have fun. Both hands right there. Go ahead and turn towards me a little bit, just like that, and pause for a moment. We're going to do a couple of thingies. I'm going to help you get in the right spot by turning you this way. And you can sneak your heels just over the edge. Terrific. Whenever you're ready, a great big deep knee bend, lean back, straighten, straighten, keep your feet right there.
To Sean, I think it's amazing. We're all nervous about something different.
Mm-hmm.
Where am I going? What do you think? Can my camera see him?
It's
gauge.
Very tiring to do that all the time.
Yeah.
It is hard to gauge.
Because I think you feel like you're coming in faster than you really are. How long does it take? I mean, it's impossible to judge time when you're on it.
It's about 14 seconds long.
How long is this one?
This one will only be about 6 or 7 seconds long.
It feels exactly like that, but it feels longer too. Like, it's weird, you know?
It's amazing how short the time really is, but something happens with the time.
Well, I said to Sean, when we watch the film later, we're going to think, boy, it was just that fast. It didn't feel like it was just
copy
that
Seneca cat. What's interesting here is you'll find that when you do this of the day, you feel like you're going really fast. We're going to do one more zip after that, and you'll be able to see the crew behind us, if we're lucky, zipping. It looks like they're going faster than you just went. It's amazing.
So
come on down one step.
So you're like, I was going that fast.
Yeah. Whenever you get that.
Am I good?
That's perfect. Through the first three zips because she kept on kind of like blanking out, just like she knew what to do but she couldn't do it. She got so nervous that she just kind of froze up. Copy that, send in cat. That happens once in a while.
Adrenaline, you know, can kind of take people over.
Yep. Come on down one step and then duck your head over to this side. Get those hands up so they're in regular riding position. You're going to leave right from there. You're good to go. Life in the mines today.
You know,
hi-ho, hi-ho.
The canary is still alive, so it's good.
Then it's cat.
Send in somebody.
Remember, you're gonna break lightly the whole time. When you leave here, step away from that edge. Just walk a leap of faith, right?
Leap of faith. So I can't lean back first, right? My best landing yet. A good jumper.
From that top jump step.
Was that a good jump?
It was a good jump.
It was a good jump.
You're a good jumper.